Welcome back, gang, for the first time and hopefully many more to come. Don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel and click on the notifications right here, this little bell, so you can get those emails every time we go live. Peace.
You know, eventually, when you've been in the sport so much, I say there's no surprises. The only, like, time a surprise happens is when someone sets off your timing. That way, you know, you got caught because for a second, you know, yeah, like, you know, if I do one of these, like, little juke, and then I come up, like, I juke down, and they, you know, they react a certain way, and then I come up with the hook instead of coming, look like I'm coming down, you know, whoop, whoop, you know what I mean? That's a little bit of a surprise, but for the most part, I mean, my eyes are vigilant of pump fakes and all that stuff too, you know what I mean? So for the most part, there's no real surprises because I've been doing this for 20-some years. You know, all you have, to me, I break boxing down in angles. You only have two things. You have straight punches, you know, other side. Straight punches, other side now. Boom. And then you have wide punches, you know, round punches. And, you know, for the most part, it's this and this, you know. But you do have the uppers. You do have the uppers, you know. But there's a lot of fights. You watch, you guys are boxing fans, you watch a lot of fights, the uppercut doesn't get utilized the most. It's hard to sneak in, you can't really use it from the outside all the time, you know what I mean? I like the left uppercut because I like every angle, and one of the angles that aren't used the most is this one, and this one is the lead hand, so I feel like you can use it more than, you know, I mean, if I'm just double jabbing, you know, that knockout was double jab, boom, down here, you know? So, you know, you can always use the uppercut when you can use the uppercut, but, you know, you don't see people really, you know, it's a 1, 2, 3, not, yeah, 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 you know? You don't see a shadow boxing all the time, just, yeah, 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 you know? I mean, the uppercut, you know, it's just that special angle. So, like, so I know, like, I'm moving backwards, right? But I'm moving backwards as long as there's distance, right? As long as there's distance, it's almost like poker. I've been in this game so long, I don't know the real numbers, but it's almost like poker, right? Like, if I have ace-king and you have king-queen, the odds are I'm supposed to win, right? There's, like, those percentages. You know when you watch the poker, they have all these percentages? Yeah. So to me, when there's a distance, when there's good distance, the percentage of him throwing a left hook is lower, right? You see what I'm saying?
Because he exposes himself.
Like, I can break down boxing to the point to where it's going to be a whole, everything is based off of range. The majority of the outcome of shit is based off of range. You know what I mean? So if I'm like this, you know what I mean? And you're starting to feel comfortable, right? So when that tee off, whenever you want to tee off, you know what I mean? But he's most likely, and he chose a straight right, you know?
You don't
but it, that's fine. That's fine. So I was gonna say, okay, so let's do it again, right? So now he jabs, right? So, but the first one was a straight right. Statistically, when there's distance, and we're doing some work, you know what I mean? When there's distance, whatever punch he's gonna lead with, a lot of times, is gonna be
the jab.
Right?
So the percentage
unless
is high.
It's a little higher on the jab side, but if he's eager to land power, you know what I mean? And if he has a good right hand, he might, you know, you're a fight right hand fighter, some are really known for their right hands. You know what I'm saying? But the jab comes out a little bit more often from the outside. The real power punch that most likely that he would lead with from the outside is the right hand, you know what I mean? And every once in a while, it's easier to see from the outside, he might lead with the left hook, but it's less common because it's gonna be a big leaping punch.
And exposing himself.
He's exposed, you know what I mean? So it's a little bit less common, right? Let's say I'm going this way, right? Now I'm going this way, right? But as I'm going this way, right? Like, I don't care, cut off the ring, right? So watch this, right? Watch this. This is something I like to show people. First off, you would never do that, so please don't do that. Okay?
Get too close?
No. Yeah. Like, watch. You go around the ring, right? Even if I cut off the ring, right? I'm gonna cut off the ring, right? This is me cutting off exactly. And go, right? See, this is kind of like me staying with you, see, so I can get you, right? But go, you know? You wouldn't do this because that's how Danny Jacobs got dropped after he dropped Mora, right? And he stayed in Jacobs' face and boom, he got dropped, right? So you really don't, you know, you normally don't really chase someone and stay in their face unless if it's a little different and you're like Porter and you're already here on them as you're going. I can keep pushing. If my hands are already on you and you're trying to go and I can stay with you with my legs and I can stay down here, you know, then I can kind of rush with you, but most likely what you'll do, because that ain't fun, right? Most likely what you'll do is you'll stop and you'll hold my ass. Mm-hmm. Stop and hold. Yeah, you know, then you just stop, you know? It's getting like you want to do that all day. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I just cut that out.
But the funny thing is, right, so for me, a lot has to do with angles, right? So in my mind, right, whenever a fighter's moving this way, nope, I'm moving that way, you know? Whenever fire's moving that way, right? I think, you know, obviously, throw a hook, throw a big hook. I'm moving that way. I'm moving away. And your hook's coming this way. Throw your hook. Your hook's coming this way. But every step, I'm stepping to the left. So even if I'm just stepping to the left, you're most likely not going to leave with a left hook. And if you do, it's fine. I'm already going away from it anyway. You know what I mean? Even then, jab hook. But I've been moving this way. You know what I mean? So what you would do to get the most out of it is you might, you know, double jab. So I'm moving this way, double jab. I'm moving this way, double jab, right hook. Boom. You know what I mean? Double jab, right hook. See, I'm moving. Boom. I'm moving into it. You know? Boom. To the body. Boom. Just touch. Overhand. Yeah, you know, see, I'm moving into it, you know what I mean? So when I'm moving, if I'm moving to the right, you don't have to cut because then, you know, you try to follow me, then I'll just switch sides, blah blah blah. I ain't worried about that, you know. But don't worry about that. Just watch where I go. Okay. Watch where I go, right? If I'm circling exactly, right? I'm circling right now. This is that time where people like to throw the right cross. They don't mind, you know, people don't really mind when they're going to the right. They'll reach across for that right, you know, they'll reach across. But the more uppity they go, like the more like curved and stuff, you know, the more curved and stuff. Like McDonald's. And I'm going, you know what I mean? It's short, but if they stay straight, you know, they might get those crosses when people are, you know what I mean? They might be able to get them.
Down. So it'll happen a little bit?
Yeah, you know, that's, you know, you duck down. You know,
mm-hmm.
You know, you can get caught there, but really go, you know, you go this way. So you're coming into the left hook. You're coming into the left hook.
Coming from both.
You know, so when I'm moving around the ring, if I'm moving this way, I'm only worrying about right hand, left hook. You might want to reach across, right? You might want to reach across, but now because I'm moving this way, eventually, when you've been in the sport so much, I say there's no surprises. The only like time a surprise happens is when someone sets off your timing. That way, you know, you got caught because for a second, you know, yeah, like, you know, if I do one of these like juke and then I come up, like I juke down and they, you know, they
game react
a certain way and then I come up with a hook instead of coming, it looked like I'm coming down, you know, whoa, whoa, you know what I mean? That's a little bit of a surprise, but for the most part, I mean, my eyes are vigilant of pump fakes and all that stuff too, you know what I mean? So for the most part, there's no real surprises because I've been doing this for 20 some years. You know, all you have, to me, I break boxing down in angles. You only have two things. You have straight punches, you know, other side now, boom, and then you have wide punches, you know, round punches. And, you know, for the most part, it's this and this, you know, but you do have the uppers, you know, But there's a lot of fights. You watch, you guys are a boxing fan, you watch a lot of fights. The uppercut doesn't get utilized the most. It's hard to sneak in. You can't really use it from the outside all the time. You know what I mean? I like the left uppercut because I like every angle, and one of the angles that aren't used the most is this one, and this one is the lead hand, so I feel like you can use it more than, you know, I mean, if I'm double jabbing, you know, that knockout was double jab, boom, down here, you know? So, you know, you can always use the uppercut when you can use the uppercut, but, you know, you don't see people really, you know, it's a 1, 2, 3, not, you don't see a shadow boxing all the time, just you know, I mean, the uppercut, you know, it's just that special angle. So I know, like, I'm moving backwards, right? But I'm moving backwards as long as there's distance, right? As long as there's distance, it's almost like poker. I've been in this game so long, I don't know the real numbers, but it's almost like poker, right? Like, if I have ace, king, and you have king, queen, the odds are I'm supposed to win, right? There's like those percentages. You know when you watch the poker, they have all those percentages?
Yeah.
So to me, when there's a distance, when there's good distance, the percentage of him throwing a left hook is lower, right?
Mm. See what I'm saying?
Because it exposes himself. Like, I can break down boxing to the point to where it's going to be a whole... Everything is based off of range. The majority of the outcome of shit is based off of range. You know what I mean? So if I'm like this, you know what I mean? And you're starting to feel comfortable, right? So when that tee off, whenever you want him tee off, you know what I mean? But he's most likely, and he chose a straight right, you know?
You don't
but that's fine. So I was gonna say, okay, so let's do it again, right? So now he jabs, right? So, but the first one was a straight right. Statistically, when there's distance, and we're doing some work, you know what I mean? When there's distance, whatever punch he's gonna lead with, a lot of times, is gonna be the jab, right?
So the percentage
unless
is higher.
It's a little higher on the jab side, but if he's eager to land power, you know what I mean? And if he has a good right hand, he might, you know, you're a fighting right hand fighter, some are really known for their right hand. You know what I'm saying? But the jab comes out a little bit more often from the outside. The real power punch that most likely that he would lead with from the outside is the right hand. You know what I mean? And every once in a while, it's easier to see from the outside. He might lead with the left hook, but it's less common because it's going to be a big leaping punch.
And it's less, himself.
He's exposed. You know what I mean? So it's a little bit less common, right? Let's say I'm going this way, right? I'm going this way, now I'm going this way, right? But as I'm going this way, right, like I'm gonna cut off the ring, right? So watch this, right? Watch this. This is something I like to show people. First off, you would never do that, so please don't do that. Okay?
Get too close?
No. Yeah. Like watch. You go around the ring, right? Even if I cut off the ring, right? I'm gonna cut off the ring, right? This is me cutting off.
Exactly. And go, right?
And go, right? Right? See? So this is kind of like me staying with you, see, so I can get to you, right? But go, you know? You want to do this because that's how Danny Jacobs got dropped after he dropped Mora, right? Mm-hmm. And he stayed in Jacobs' face and boom, he got dropped, right? So you really don't, you know, you normally don't really chase someone and stay in their face unless if it's a little different. And you're like quarters, and you're already here on them as you're going. I can keep pushing you. If my hands are already on you, and you're trying to go, and I can stay with you with my legs, and I can stay down here, you know, then I can kind of rush with you. But most likely what you'll do, because that is fun, right? Most likely what you'll do is you'll stop. And you'll hold my ass.
Mm-hmm.
Stop and hold. Stop and hold. Yeah, you know, then you just stop, you know? Because you ain't like you want to do that all day. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I just cut that out.
But the funny thing is, right, so for me, a lot has to do with angles, right? So in my mind, right, whenever a fighter is moving this way, nope, I'm moving that way, you know? Whenever a fighter is moving that way, right, I think, you know, obviously, throw a hook, throw a big hook. I'm moving that way. I'm moving out. I'm moving away.
Your hook's coming this way. Throw your hook. Your hook's coming this way. But every step, I'm stepping to the left. So even if I'm just stepping to the left, you're most likely not going to lead with a left hook. And if you do, it's fine. I'm already going away from it anyway.
So maybe a jab.
You know what I mean? Even that jab hook. But I've been moving this way. You know what I mean? So what you would do to get the most out of it is you might, you know, double jab. So I'm moving this way, double jab. I'm moving this way, double jab, right hook. Boom. You know what I mean? Double jab, right hook. Boom. I'm moving into it. You know? Boom. To the body. Boom. Just touch. Pull the hand. Yeah, you know? See? I'm moving into it. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So when I'm moving, if I'm moving to the right, you don't have to cut it, because then, you know, you try to follow me, then I'll just switch sides, blah, blah, blah. I ain't worried about that, you know? But don't worry about that. Just watch where I go. Okay. Watch where I go, right? If I'm circling exactly, right? I'm circling, right? Now, this is that time where people like to throw the right cross. They don't mind. You know, people don't really mind when they're going to the right. They'll reach across for that, right? You know, they'll reach across. But the more uppity they go, like the more like curved and stuff, you know, the more curved and stuff.
Like Madonna
stuff. And I'm going, you know what I mean? It's short, but if they stay straight, you know, they might get those crosses when people are, you know what I mean? They might be able to get them.
Duck it down. So you're not having a movement?
Yeah, you know? You duck down, you know?
Mm-hmm.
You know, you can get caught there, but really going you know, you go this way. So you're coming into the left hook. You're coming into the left hook. You know? So when I'm moving around the ring, if I'm moving this way, I'm only worried about right hand, left hook. Because you might want to reach across, right? You might want to reach across, but now because I'm moving this way, you can get, I'm coming into this damage. Because you're walking the power punch. Yeah, so you might reach across. You know, even if you just go like a 1, 2, 3, you know, 1, 2, 3. See, if I'm walking this way, you throw the one, throw the right cross. See, you throw the cross across your body, cross. So I'm moving this way, you're gonna aim, and then you come up with the left foot.
Where did you get that info? I heard you was in the camp.
Boom. You know, moving into it, right? If I'm moving this way and you throw 1, 2, 3,
see,
that hook becomes nothing. 1, 2, that hook becomes out of the way, right? That's why I said when someone's moving this way, jab, right? You know? So to me, when people aren't even smart enough to throw the punch that is what I call the collision punch.
But you were
collision punch. The collision punch.
Oh, you did? Okay.
You know, fighters move this way, you throw the punch into them. This is what I tell amateurs, right? I don't throw. When people are like, you know, you're a champ, what's going on, Keith? Sometimes they ask me, like, what's going on in your head? Like, nothing. Nothing. I'm not thinking nothing. I'm aware and I'm ready for everything. Distance-wise, I naturally know from the outside we're going to play this poke game until we get a little closer. Then I might throw some power. And if you're standing there taking this power, I might be in position for a hook. If you back up and you don't take the power, then where's my hook? My hook now is leading. Is a jumping, you know, event, you know. Distance is a big thing, you know.
Maybe you can't. Because he's with Eddie.
Like even
Chisora, like Chisora would be good.
You just touch my chest. Chisora
would be good.
You just touch my chest.
Yeah.
It's tough. Yeah. You're tough.
Nah. You know, you gotta keep winning.
You know. So
you gotta keep winning.
So he's actually touching. But it's fingertips.
Yeah,
right?
I'm reaching fingertips. He's reaching.
So that's because what I'm doing is I know distance very well, right? So what I'm doing is I'm keeping myself when you come. I'm keeping myself on that edge of his jab. So even if the jab was to land, it's only at the edge. It's not like do it now. It's not like that. He's not gonna boom get me with a jab. You know what I mean? It's just grazing. You know, and fighters know that too, you know, so from a lot, you know, with the right distance, it's hard to do to get these hooks out unless they're going to be wide, you know? Or you might have to do something where you step in before you hook, you know? But my eyes, I'm looking, you know, like for me, it's 50-50. It's Omer or 25-25-25. For the most part, you're most likely coming straight, you know what I mean? But then the question is, straight punches is like this, you know? Wah, wah, straight. Hooks,
circular.
Shoulders open up, you know what I mean? Shoulders open up, you know? And like I said, if I'm moving this way, there's no, yeah, go ahead, slap it. Yeah. There's no point, if I'm moving this way, there's no real point in throwing that left hook, but if you're throwing the right hook, then you're doing collision punching. You're being smart enough to just throw the punch I'm walking into, you know what I mean? Boom, so in case if it happened, you know? But this is what I like to tell basic people, a lot of amateurs, you really gotta focus on collision punching, body hit. Bomb, bomb. If they're moving in this direction, double jab. Bomb, bomb. And they're moving in this direction, boom. You aim the power punch in the direction your opponent's already moving in.
The impact.
You don't have to think about no crazy combo. Just let that impact. He's moving this way, so I stop. If he's moving this way, this hand. No, this hand. This hand. Hook. Yeah. You know? I'm moving away. There's no point. Collision punching is the most devastating, you know? Here. You know? Huh? Huh? Body. That's not. I'm going this way, see? Then see? And then if I'm going to the right, you go to my body. If I stop, now you can throw the left hook. Boom. See? But if I'm moving this way, you throw the left hook first. No, I'm moving this way, you throw the left hook first to the body. You know, like you throw and into the head. See? Like, and I'm already going around you. See? See? You know? It's just a little bit off. You catch me, you walk that way. You know? Pop, boom, boom. You catch him. Boom. He's walking in there. He stops. He takes that. Now he stopped. Boom. Now the left hook. If he's been moving that way, you don't want him left hook. You just go around me, not out.
Okay.
Like around. Short. Boom.
I seen
sometimes, you know, if they're moving slowly, right? They're moving slowly, like just. Yeah. They're moving slowly that way, you know. Sometimes you can. Boom. Get that left hook. They're just moving like this. You know what I mean? Sometimes you can still they're moving in that direction. They're moving away, but they're not moving away at a fast enough rate or anything. But somebody who gets real circular, gets real boxy like me, you know, I feel like I can't be trapped. Because my thing is, even I love collision punching. It's how I set up all my combos, right? It's how I set up all my combos. If you know, you coming straight with a jab, you know, you coming straight with a jab, wow, boom. You're coming into me, so the collision punch is the straight right hand, see? So it doesn't matter if it's forward, backwards, or side to side, it's all about that collision, you know?
Magnifies the power.
Yeah, it magnifies the power, you know? But that's why I like, whatever the movement is, tells me how to set up my combos. If you're moving to the right, if you're moving to the left, if backward, you duck down like this, you know what I'm saying? The more of a habit you have, if I can pick up on it, I might be able to utilize something about your habit.
So it's just analyzing this fight round by round when you're fighting out there. It's just...
Yeah, I just do everything off of movement, reach, speed, movement, and the foot. You know what I mean? The foot. Because I can't touch you, right? Mm-hmm. Unless if I wanted to lean my chin forward, right? I can't touch you unless if my foot
is
like 2 inches in front of your foot. I know my distance, see, I can touch you. See, look, I stepped there and I told him I could touch him, right? Mm-hmm. If I put my foot here, I can touch you. Boom, 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 boom. You know? If we're toe to toe, I can throw all uppercuts and hooks. I can throw inside uppercuts, inside punching. If I'm toe to toe, this is inside zone. If I'm here, I can touch you. I can touch you. If I'm outside of here, the only way I can touch you outside of my jab zone, a little outside of my jab zone, is to lean forward, get on my front foot, and I can hit you with the right hand. Because everybody knows that the jab is in the back. The right hand, when it gets thrown, it goes a little past it because your center comes up. Like how
golfers, when they're done, when they're done, they're in front. When you're done with your right hand, you're in front now. So the, you know, the old school knockouts? Old school knockouts when they're like doing this little jab. They're just jabbing. They're just jabbing, and they're not even touching them yet. And then they just with that big right hand.
Big right hand. That's that, that dude, the Jewish Hammer, did his last fight, bro. He was just...
Hebrew Hammer.
And it was funny because it was watching, like watching one of the old school guys. When he let that right hand loose, bro, this guy's head looked like it blew up. Boom! What round did he take him out at?
Fourth or fifth?
Fourth round. Because I never heard of this guy. Never heard of him.
So it's funny. Like I said, amateur, they go this way, boom, boom, boom. Collision. You're going this way, one, two, three. You're going into that last power punch, you know? So let's say... So when you're boxing, right, you're moving this way, right? Remember, I said they might want to reach across with this one, right? But then you got to watch out for that hook, right? But let's say you're going this way, right? And this dude, he's only got that distance, but now he just steps here, and he's about to unleash that big hook, you know? So you just go that way, and you just roll. Wow.
Oh, I
see
you do that too.
Bro. I know you see me do it.
I know you see me do it.
Now you see me do that. Real technique.
That's
you know
crazy.
What I mean? Because if you're smart, you're gonna try to set up this collision punching. It's the most effective punching. I've been doing it since I was 13 years old. I even practiced it on the heavy bag. If you wanna practice collision punching, all you gotta do is move the heavy bag like this. Tell the boy to time it, step up and throw the left hook at the right time, you know? So, you know, ha, as it's coming down, ha, right when it hits center, you should be making that contact. You can do the same thing with the right. Obviously, I'm not gonna do it as hard, boom. You can do the same thing with the right, boom. It's just collision. This is just a visual, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So what happens is when I throw a combo and I want to practice collision punching, the thing is you throw the 1-2 while it's in its upswing and you throw the power hot, hot,
on the downswing.
While it's on the downswing. Mm. You see?
Start doing that.
Collision punching. You know what I mean? By vision, pop, pop, pop. You know? Remember we said, see? Jab, jab, right hook. Jab, jab, right hook, left hook. See? Unleash your combo, but in the combo, get a collision effect. Then finish off your combo. Boom, boom, collision effect. Pop, pop, pop. Then finish off your combo. Back out. Boom, boom, jab. You know what I mean? It's moving forward and backwards. Your collision is, you know, you can just
that center,
pop.
Yeah.
Just the jab real simple. Or, hop, boom, time that right hand. Hop, boom, time that right hand. It's coming at you, you know? This guy is, hop, boom, on that way in. So I do this. This is actually my bag work. This has been my bag work drill since I was 13 years old. Once with my coach used to actually make the bag swing like this, and then only he actually marked the ground. Step here. He used to mark the ground. Step here. Get down. Step here. Power hook. That's how we practiced. And then he would swing it again. All right. Do it again.
Damn.
You know? You know, it's just a timing thing, you know, but you get used to this, right? And then you bring it into your sparring. Once when the kid's walking that way, jab, jab, right hook. It's I'm not throwing the power punch I want to throw. I throw the power punch you move into.
Least resistance.
Yeah, I mean,
it's coming.
You're coming in. It's like he's walking this way, so you shut the door. He's walking, so you shut the door. You know what I mean?
I like that.
You shutting the door, but he wasn't even trying to get in. He was going that way. He was going out this way. Now you gotta shut that door on him. He's going this way, you shut that door on him. Yeah. Shut the door, man. So the slip though is like, it's funny because technique layers itself, right? So first you practice the collision punching, right? But if you wanna, when you practice offensive, right? You gotta think defensive too. So that's what I was saying. When you're good, I'm moving this way, you throw the left hook. No, I'm moving into it. Don't you worry about it. You just step, you step and make me, you know, boom. You know what I mean? Double jab right. Boom. You know, double jab right. Block. Doesn't matter, you know what I mean? If the angle I'm coming in, body. You know, boom, you know,
So you, as you get used to it, you slip naturally, right? You slip, you prevent that collision, right? He's smart enough to try to get the collision, and you read it enough to get out of the collision. This is where boxing becomes like chess. You know, you're reading these movements. Yeah. You notice I'm moving here. You notice I'm moving here. You double jab. I notice your shoulders cock back during your double jab, so I know you're about to unleash it. Then when you do, I don't let it come. But you were smart enough to get the collision, and I was smart enough to evade the collision, even though I'm still moving in the collision, into the collision. So sometimes you'll find yourself in boxing moving towards the punch, even while you're trying to escape from the punch. That's why trainers will tell you, don't be afraid of the punch.
Because you could actually discalibrate the other person's balance by making them miss so hard, I guess, right?
But and that opens up counters.
If you really don't want them to slip, you throw it to the bottom.
They got
to move that. You throw it to the body. Yeah. But we know everybody loves the head hunt.
What?
Head hunt. Call of Duty, baby. Boost. Ta-ta-ta-ta. Headshot, boy. Got you. Got the highlights.
Yeah, you know? So, what else is it? If you
slip in. So then the funny thing is normally, right, when you're inexperienced and someone puts that body shot on you, boom, you're going to stop. Right? You're going to stop.
Yeah.
Then that allows them to throw more combos. Boom and boom. Okay? It allows them to finish off a combo, right? But let's say you finally cut me off in the corner. You're going to double jab right hook me, right? But I don't want to be here for the rest of the combo, right?
Yeah. You just want to take that impact and you want to get out of there.
What am I supposed to do?
I hit you right here.
And what am I supposed to do?
Go back.
I'm on the ropes.
Go the other way.
Take the impact and
go
slip.
This way. This way?
Nah, because
the way his hook's about to
come. Yeah, because the next punch.
Well, if you're reading it, can you slip that hook?
I can. You're right. So if I am reading it, and I'm stopping, I can start my motion here.
Yeah.
If I am reading it, right?
Now, if you don't.
But if I don't even want to deal with that punch, double jab, right hook, what happens is I take this block, but I do what's called I push through it.
I run through it,
right? So, watch. Like you just move this way, right? And just, you know, right? So move this way, you know? But as this is about to hit you, say, I'm going through it, I don't care, right? So
it's like a bum rush
through it. I'm taking off my arm. No, yeah, you go through it, right? So here, watch. Double J. See, so where's that left hook now? Now I bounce.
It doesn't matter.
You took away my camera.
I show you if I'm in the ring, right? Because like I said, sometimes what will happen is, right, I'm walking this way. You're slowly cutting the ring off, right? No, you already got me pretty much. We're almost here, right? So you slowly cut the ring off. So now I'm still walking. You're like, fuck that. I'm gonna step up and I'm gonna stop him with this left hook. Mm-hmm. He's gonna stop and I have him in the corner, right? So you step up. No, step up first. You're like punching. Yeah, step up there. Boom, and I push through that. See, you ain't gonna stop me from getting my roto. If I want to be on a different side of you, I'll be on a different side of you. Because think about it. If you want to throw the combo, right? So just like I did, right? Like touch, right? After you touch me with the left hook, just go ahead and just touch me with the rest of the combo. Where's the rest of the combo?
You got me reaching.
Where's the rest of the combo? It's not there because you want to do this, then you want to do this, which means you want me here. So if you do this, and then before, as this is coming out, I'm already here now. Where's that? Because I'm pushing through it, right? So, you know, we can do it from the right side, you know? But if I still go, the combo's not there. Because if I stay, then you just come back with the left, boom, exactly, you just rotate. But if as long as I don't stay, go left and then go right. Do it nice and smooth.
Right,
you
know,
right.
Exactly.
Right.
Right. Right. Right. Right. Because you're going to slap.
Double jab, right, left. You know, I'm coming this way. Yeah. Let's do double jab right left.
That's what you see that way.
Where's that? See? So
I can get through.
Right? Left side.
Where's the right trunks? Left and right.
You ain't come with none of that. But now he's still out the way. That's all he's doing. Slide.
Yeah. It's uncomfortable if you don't stay still. I see.
Like, there's no way you grab the box. Like, you talk.
See? And then
I would have to grab it.
There's nothing. You don't have, you don't have a combo.
You don't have a combo.
Yeah, but you gotta have a combo.
Go. And as you commit, if I stop, I freeze,
you give your combo in there.
That's where you fold the combo. So that's why I have so much confidence, because I control my feet. And I'm your target. So when I'm moving like this, and I'm moving like this, and you want to double jab right, double jab here.
Oh,
slip, you know what I mean? Then I'm back over here, you know?
Okay,
and I push down.
I'm not going to stop for you.
I'm not going to stop for you.
That's what
I'm
really
let you be in here. The only fighter I ever stopped for was Sean Porter. I stopped for him. You know what I mean? But if I don't want to stop, I'm not stopping.
That's
you control.
I control me. This is me in the ring. So if I want to be here, I'm here. If I want to fucking move, I move. Fighters forget to move. Fighters forget to stay calm and just understand that if you're bouncing and someone's coming at you in attack, especially the more they come at you straight, boom, they have to adjust. See, whenever someone goes around, the straight guy, he has to adjust eventually. This is a round, you know, he has to adjust, you know? So, I mean, from head to toe, I just understand the game, baby.
I'm using all of that. You hear me, Coach Mitty, man? Using all of that.
Collision.
You get late.
You need to make weight.
I'm going to make the weight.
Make weight, son.
Make weight, man. You need to make weight. The sight in the game, cause see the boxing boys.